Okay, let's bring the focus back to markets, and as we finish the week off, not so badly, remember third straight week of gains for us, we'd like to invite Navneet Munot, who's Chief Investment Officer at SBI Mutual Fund, who's joining in to walk us through what he's made of the moves that we've seen for our markets so far in 2017. Navneet, good evening, and thank you so much for taking time out for us. You know, the last couple of weeks actually haven't been all that bad for our markets. Even the internals are looking up. What are your thoughts on the investing environment in India right now?
So at this conference last year, when we had at the same venue, the mood was like quite gloomy because of the concerns about China, the concern about oil prices, concerns about US elections, Fed hike, the fears of Brexit, so on and so forth. Despite all that negative news flow, overall global markets have done quite well. Fed could do a rate hike because they are more confident about the economy. While for India, because of the outflows from the emerging markets, we got, we also got our share of outflows from the global investors. The domestic investors have kept the faith, and the flows into the mutual funds have been pretty strong. We didn't see the earnings growth that was expected at the beginning of the year, but I hope that the next year could be the year where we actually see a reversal in the earnings growth, and that leads to the returns in the market, which were quite muted in 2016, coming to the almost a double-digit level going into the 2017, mostly driven by the earnings. While the year again would have a lot of global news flow, we'll have the people who talk about the UP elections or some of the other reforms, budget, so on and so forth, but I think the overall earnings growth will be the most critical factor, and that should drive the market this year.
Okay, let's talk about the expectation from 2017, because, you know, we promised our viewers that we will discuss that. Last year, as far as markets go, very forgettable, minimal returns on the Nifty. Do you think that this year stocks will give better returns than what we saw in 2016?
So both the far out, I have to take a view on the far out, it's better to look at the history far behind. So if you look at last, since the inception of Sensex, I think if I remember, 1986-87 were those 2 years where markets didn't deliver much returns. I think one of them was flat and one of them was negative. Next was, I think, 95-96, when market didn't deliver returns for two consecutive years. Then you had 2000 and 2001, where for two consecutive years market was down. After that, we haven't really seen any period where for 2 years market did not deliver return or was rather negative. I think a third year logically should be good. If I look back last year, in fact, look at the reforms that have happened, bankruptcy code, GST code, I mean, you had the Aadhaar bill, you had monetary policy committee now getting formed and operational, you had a real estate regulatory bill. I mean, a series of reforms last year, with good monsoon, with 7-day commission periods, but despite all that, markets did not have the return. As I mentioned, one is the earnings, and also I think maybe some concerns about the global outflows from the emerging markets. I think things should fall in place going forward after the initial pains that we have seen from the demonetization. I think the structural gains are yet to be seen.
Okay, that's, you know, you're sounding pretty optimistic. Let's talk about how the flows into the industry, the mutual fund industry and your own funds has been. You know, so many folks that we talk to here on the channel talk about how clearly 2016 has seen the big return of the retail investor and how domestic inflows are the backbone now of this market. But is this a trend that you think is likely to stick?
So I think our view over the last couple of years has consistently been that I think the retail flows in India will surprise on upside. So I remember almost 2.5 years back, people thought when the first 1 lakh crore came, is it the peak of the market? And my view was that no. I think investors are a lot more mature. Investors are looking at long term. Investors are looking at asset allocation. They're getting their asset allocation right. There's a lot of money moving in from the real assets to the financial assets. And I think this is a structural trend in India. I think all the awareness that has been created, the regulatory measures that have been taken, the hard work that has been done by the industry and the advisors, I think we have a long way to go in terms of channelizing the savings into the equity markets. Pension funds have just started investing. So I think this is a structural trend, and I think the Tina factor is likely to work in our favor. Look at the way deposit rates have gone down. Look at what's happening in the real estate market and the gold. I think the flows will continue, and it kind of demographic books we have, the savings pools that we have among the households, we have a long way to go.
Let's talk about your view on earnings then, you know, both third quarter and the fourth quarter. So far of what we've seen, it hasn't been all that bad. Even IT companies that have been under the cloud for a while have put out a pretty steady show. But given the note ban and the likely impact that it is, you know, going to have on India Inc. Scorecards, what do you think, by when can the actual earnings rebound come in?
So very honestly, last 2-3 quarters, every quarter I would have mentioned maybe we are just like one quarter away. I'll get it right in one of those quarters where I think the earnings are likely to recover. But some of the things that were dragging down the earnings, and that's where the hope was that global commodity prices have recovered, the NPO challenges are getting recognized as well as resolved. Some of the challenges and then some of the exporters, the IT, healthcare, the other engineering exporters and all, as the global economy recovers, I think they will be a beneficiary. We have seen last 3 or 4 months exports recovering in India. We'll have good monsoon, so the rural economy is likely to do well. The government spending is picking up, so industries should do well. If interest rates are going down, the overall leverage levels and households are increasing, I think that will be good for the private banks and NBFCs. Now, we have seen some challenges in last 1 or 2 months in some of these sectors, but structurally, I remain positive. I think the nominal GDP growth, which was like almost in single digit, is likely to be almost 11-12% at least going forward. And I think with the overall better global environment, and I think the impact of all the reforms that have been taken in last 2 years, resulting into the ultimately better corporate profits, will be shown in numbers in next few quarters.
Right, and last but not the least, Navneet, let's talk about the budget. According to you, what's going to be a good budget?
Biggest thing I'm watching for in this budget is, I think, the simplification of tax regime. To improve the tax compliance, I think it's very critical that we make our overall tax regime, the tax collection mechanism, quite simple. And I think something like people can download an app and just put their Aadhaar number and maybe some more details and they pay tax, and you know, a large number of people are not asked any question because the government trusts them. But the people who really evade something, I think they are really taken to the task. I mean, they have to be punished very severely. Something like that, I think, is very critical. While the GST, the demonetization, all the other efforts that our government has taken will lead to better tax revenues going forward, but structurally, I think that's one of the most critical things because a large part of the population is still out of the overall tax regime. The another thing I'm sure that the government spending on infrastructure is people will be watching. I think that needs to pick up a lot more because private capex will take some more time to pick up. The third thing, again related to the tax regime I mentioned, that was more about the simplification, but if the Donald Trump is going to cut tax rates very severely, and if it is followed by most of the other countries in the world, I think India will also have to do the same. So while we have to make the tax regime more simpler, I think we'll also have to cut the tax rates to make businesses investing in India. And I think some of those things are the most critical that I would be watching for. We have some sense of what's likely to come on 31st of December when PM announced some of the measures for the rural economy, affordable housing. I think those are the themes that one should look forward to. I think those are the structural themes where I'm sure government has tremendous focus.
Oh yes, absolutely. Navneet, thank you so much for taking time out for us. Navneet Munot there, CIO of SBI Mutual Fund, walking us through what he's made of the investing environment right now, and of course expectations from the budget. Structurally continues to remain bullish on the India story. Let's take a short break and we'll put the spotlight on India Now.